couple things before we get started. I like to demo before, even if you've seen it a million times. It's really good to keep this in the back of your mind as you practice, because a lot of people who do yoga and don't really think about biomechanics are the ones who have shoulder issues or their knees get wonky. And that's over the course of years. So I'm all about proper mechanics. And a couple of things are during warriors and, of course, during chaturangas. So let me demo a couple of things real quick, and then we'll get started with our practice. I'm starting to show, by the way. Oh, my God. You see that? 15 weeks, and it's like, boom! But anyway, with the chaturanga, you want your elbows into your side body, okay? A lot of people, when they do chaturangas, they think of a push-up, and their elbows are outside. By the way, if you haven't already, just mute your account so that you can hear me clearly. So on the bottom left, you'll press mute. And at the end, when we stretch, we can definitely say hi again. And on the top right, if you want to put me on speaker view, that would be helpful. So elbows are into your side body. So when you are doing a chaturanga, you want to think of three compartments being super tight. That's going to be your belly, your thighs, and your glutes. So when you shift your weight forward, you're driving your shoulders away from your ears. Your eyes are on the ground. You're on the tips of your toes or the ball mounts of your feet. You come down 90 degrees. That is all you need. From here, your elbows are in. You're going to untuck your toes. You're going to send the chest through the arms, and you're pushing the ground away. You're unclenching the glutes to relax the lower back. Your eyes are forward or your eyes are up. And then you go to downward facing dog, which means you're just hollowing your belly. You're sending your head in between your arms, and you're relaxing. Let it go. Don't hold on to any tension in the upper body. Okay, so I'll give you those cues throughout the practice. With warriors, today we're doing warrior two. We're not doing warrior one. But you want to think about externally rotating this hip and locking out this leg. If this leg is kind of hanging out, you're putting this knee at risk. When you squeeze your quad, you're actually supporting the knee capsule. And with this knee, you want the knee to face forward. You don't want it to buckle in. Okay, so just look at yourself while you set yourself up. You should feel real strong in these postures. And if you don't, adjust accordingly and it'll feel much better. Okay? So let's all start in child's pose. Okay? Child's pose. We're going to bring the big toes together. Your knees are going to go nice and wide. And you're going to bring your forehead to the ground. And allow your belly to fall in between your knees. And just allow yourself to dissolve into your mat. Allow your glutes to connect to your heels. And we're going to flip the palms to face the sky. Really opening up the shoulders. And just let's activate those arms slightly. Just lift your elbows off the ground so that you feel your arms active without elevating your shoulders towards your ears. Take a moment here to soften the breath. And to scan your body from head to toe. Notice where you're holding on to tension. Many folks who sit throughout the day tend to feel their lower back a little tight. Perhaps your hips feel tight. Breathe into those spaces. And with every inhale, visualize that breath going into those particular areas. And with every exhale, let go of that tension. Take a deep breath in through your nose for four counts. Hold your breath at the top. And then slowly let it go for four, three, two, and one. Just allow your breath to become natural. You're going to seal your lips and just creating heat in the body. And let's flip the palms to face the ground. Let's take your head side to side, feeling a small little massage in your forehead, the space in between your eyes, your seat of intuition. Just allowing yourself to dissolve into a space of calmness while continuing the breath deep. Good. We're going to gently take our right arm and thread it underneath our left arm, and then take your right cheek down to the ground. You're going to take your left arm and wrap it all the way around your back, and then hook the hands around your right thigh.
And with every inhale, find length. And with every exhale, find depth as you rotate the spine ever so slightly toward the sky. If this feels too aggressive in your neck, you can always support your neck with a pillow underneath your head. Let's take a final breath here. Slowly let it go. And we rotate the other side. Bring yourself back to center. Nice and controlled. Bring your left arm underneath your right armpit. Take your left cheek to the ground. And then real gently take your right arm behind your back. And then attempting to hook that left thigh. Relax your shoulder away from that left ear. Let's breathe in, find length. And on the exhale, find a little bit of depth as you rotate toward the sky. Good. Breathe in deeply. Keep your mouth sealed. And slowly exhale. Good. Gently release that right arm. Bring yourself back to center. And let's make our way into all fours. So let's bring the palms directly underneath the shoulders and bring the knees directly under the hips. And then let's gently flow through a couple of cat-cows here. We drop the belly down on the inhale. We take our gaze skyward or forward. And on the exhale, we hollow and round the spine. Tuck the chin all the way to the chest. Inhale, slowly drop the belly down. Send that tailbone toward the sky. Drive the heels of the palms toward the knees. Feel that traction. And then exhale, hollow and round the spine. Then close your eyes and just find some organic movements. Whatever you need in the space. Perhaps you're rocking your hips side to side. Opening up your glutes, your IT band. Perhaps you take some small little mini neck circles back and forth. Good. Take a couple seconds here on your own. And meet me back to center. You're going to slowly take your left leg behind your right leg and just sit your hips into the right side. You're going to feel a nice left glute stretch. Keep your hands planted, eyes on the ground. Take a deep breath here. Slowly exhale. Good, uncross that left leg. Bring the right knee behind your left leg and then shift your hips to the left. Feel that stretch in the right side. You might feel a little different from one side to the next. We hold a little more tension between right and left sides. Different for each of us. Good, slowly bring it back to center. Let's tuck our toes here. And then nice and slowly walk your hands back onto your thighs and then sit your glutes onto your heels. Sit up real tall in the spine. Let's take your palms to face the sky. You're gonna feel a beautiful stretch underneath your feet. Let's close your eyes. Let's breathe in deeply here. Exhale, let it go. Good, two more deep breaths. It's gonna feel real aggressive for some of you. If the fascia in your feet is tight, this is an area of opportunity to let it go. Remember, we step down with our feet, so if our feet are tight, it's gonna go all the way up through the kinetic chain. We got to release that fascia. Breathe into that experience here. And on every exhale, release any sort of tension in the body. Good, slowly come out of it. We're gonna shake the feet out, just tap them on the ground. Beautiful, let's bring our hands a little bit forward. You're gonna tuck your toes again. You're gonna send your hips up back. Keep your knees bent at a 90 degree angle and drop your head down right here. Keep your arms so firm. You're pushing the ground away, so feel your arms strong. Allow your head to descend in between your arms. And then just check in with your hands. Make sure every single finger is rounded to the earth. And then send that tailbone to the back wall. You'll feel a nice little stretch in the back. And then slowly drop that right heel down. Keep that left knee bent. Feel that beautiful stretch through that whole right calf into the foot. And then nice and slow, straighten out the left leg. Keep that right knee bent. And just notice if you shifted your weight forward. You want to keep out of the shoulders and the wrists. And then come back to the right side. You're going to pedal between right and left leg. And just as you bring your heel to the ground, notice if that heel is falling behind the toes or if your heel is coming to the inside of the toes. You want that heel to disappear behind your toes. Beautiful. Let's drop both heels down to the ground. Downward facing dog. Just take a moment here. Just scan your body from head to toe. Notice if your body is shifting forward. Keep those hips way to the back wall. The goal is to drive the heels down, but not to force the body to do things it's not ready to do. We're still warming up here. So if you have to bend your knees, do so. If you need to drop to child's pose, that's always an option. Good, let's burn through our hands. On your next inhale, let's send that right leg straight to the back wall. And on your exhale, knee to nose, hollow around the spine, shoulders come over the wrists. Hold it here, really hollow that belly out. Take a deep breath in. On your exhale, step that right foot through. If you need to guide that right foot with your right hand, let's bring that right knee over that right ankle. Drop your left knee down. On your next inhale, we rise. Let's take one hand to our belly, one hand to our lower back, and let's tuck that pelvis underneath us. Keep a neutral spine here. You should feel a beautiful stretch through that front hip here. And if you have it in your practice, bring your arms skyward all the way up. I'm gonna change my monitor so you can see my whole body. Eyes are gonna be forward. So keeping your spine neutral, your hips neutral, if you find that dip forward, undip it by pushing forward. Keep that belly engaged, take a deep breath in. On your exhale, drop that right hand down. Let's reach over through that left arm. So you're aiming the right fingertips down to the ground. Really reach infinite amount of energy through those left fingertips. Good, deep breath in. Exhale, bring it back to center. Good, straighten out the right leg. You're gonna send the hips back with a neutral spine. You're gonna frame that right leg and just fall forward into a hamstring stretch. Flex the toes up to the sky. Good. Bring the chest through the arms, eyes on the earth. Let's breathe in here. Exhale, find some depth. Beautiful. Nice and slow. Drop that right foot down. Let's frame that right foot. Tuck your left toes under. On your inhale, send that right leg straight to the back wall. Let's square the hips to the earth. On your exhale, bring your right knee to your right tricep and hold. So really building heat in those shoulders and core. Hollow out that belly, push the earth away with your hands. On your next inhale, send the right leg straight to the back wall. Drop your head in between your arms. Exhale, right knee to the left tricep and hold. So really hollow that belly out, working that contralateral plane across the body. Really bring that knee all the way up. Inhale, send that right leg straight to the back wall. Exhale, downward facing dog. Good, reestablish that down dog. Drop your head in between your arms. Push through the heels of your palm back. Feel that stretch, no pressure in the shoulders and wrists. Take a deep inhale through your nose. Open mouth exhale. Good. On your next inhale, send that left leg straight to the back wall. Frame the left hip to the ground. Exhale, knee to nose, shoulder over the wrist. Really push the earth away. Eyes in between your thumbs. And on your exhale, step it through, low lunge. Left knee comes right above that left ankle. Let's drop that right knee to the ground. We come up all the way into this low lunge. Let's push that right hip underneath you. So one hand on your lower back, one hand on your belly. Once you feel neutral, bring your arms up. Just hold it here for a moment. Notice if you feel the stretch in that right quad, this whole right hip flexor. Take a deep breath here. On your exhale, drop that left arm down. Let's reach up through the right fingertips. You could look at your right fingertips or you could look forward, whatever feels nice in your spine. Take a deep breath in. We stay for the exhale. Good, nice and slow. Come out of that. Let's stretch out that left leg. Flex through the left toes. We're gonna frame that left leg and then reach the chest forward. That'll go right into that hamstring, right into where your calf inserts, right behind the knee. Let's flex the toes to get that whole calf engaged. And on every exhale, reach the chest further forward. Let's really get deep into that hamstring. Take a deep breath in. Open mouth exhale, let it go. Good, nice and slow. Come on up, let's place that left foot back down. Left knee goes right over the left ankle. Let's frame the left foot, tuck your right toes. On the next inhale, send that left leg straight to the back wall. Drop your head in between your arms. And on your exhale, left knee to the left tricep and hold. Shoulders directly over the wrist. Let's point the left toes, staying active in this pose. Good, inhale, left leg straight to the back wall, three-legged dog. Exhale, across your body, right to that right tricep and hold. Get that pause, hollow that belly. Think of an isometric crunch. Good, inhale, send that left leg back. On your exhale, downward facing dog. Good, so you wanna feel like you're an inverted V. So hips way to the sky, legs are straight. Unless you feel it in your lower back, then you bend your knees slightly. Good, take a deep breath in. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. On your next inhale, bend your knees, glance forward. On your next exhale, step or float to the front of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift, hands to your shins, straight back. Slight bend in the knees still. And then exhale, forward fold. Drop your head all the way down to your thighs. On your next inhale, we rise. We reach all the way to the sky. Touch your palms at the top. Exhale, hands to heart center. Good, inhale, rise. Exhale, back bend. Let's cactus the arms, send the chest forward, and then lift your lower back out of the hips, saluting the sun. Inhale, rise, reach up. Exhale, forward fold, slight bends in those knees. Melt your chest down towards your thighs. Inhale, halfway lift, straight back, eyes down. Exhale into a high plank and hold, high plank. Good, now make sure your shoulders are directly on top of the wrists. Let's firm through the thighs, your belly, and your glutes. Inhale, shift 1 inch forward. Exhale, chaturanga, elbows in, only halfway down, people. Inhale, upward facing dog, unflip the toes, and then push those hands down. Notice where your shoulders are here. If you're falling into your shoulders, push the earth away. Really firm through those triceps, and then look over the right shoulder. Take that left hip down toward the ground. And then bring it back to center. Still pushing through the arms. Look over the left shoulder. Inhale, back to center. And then exhale, tuck the toes, downward facing dog. Ah, breathe.
Down dog is a resting pose. It gives us the chance to notice where our breath goes. It's a chance to bring the breath back into the body. As we realize throughout our flow, the breath dictates when the body moves. So at all times, remain connected through the breath. We flow three times through Surya Namaskar A. On your next inhale, bend your knees, glance forward. Exhale, step or float to the front of your mat. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise, reach all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, rise, reach up again. Exhale, mini back bends, cactus the arms, salute the sun. Chest lifts, eyes up to the sky. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, vinyasa, high to low plank, chaturanga dandasana. Halfway down, inhale, flip the toes, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, bend your knees, glance forward. Exhale, travel to the front of your mat. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise, reach to the fingertips. Reach up. Exhale, hands to your heart. Inhale, rise. Exhale, back bend. Saluting the sun. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, slight bend in your knees. Chaturanga Dandasana, high to low plank. Inhale, upward facing dog, push the earth away. Exhale, hollow the belly, downward facing dog. One more time, we flow, go at your own pace. My voice shall only guide you. Once we come to the front of our mat, halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, forward fold. We move at our own pace so that we could find that meditation in our practice. Hands to heart at the top. Inhale, rise. Exhale, back bend. Inhale. We exhale as we come to our forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, chaturanga dandasana, high to low plank. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Listen up, inhale, come to a high plank. Exhale, low plank, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take three deep breaths here. Drop your head in between your arms. You could always take child's pose. Just allow yourself the appropriate recovery to stay connected. Notice where your breath is, the quality, the depth, the texture. Hey, this is your practice. It's a chance to remain connected the entire time. If you feel slightly disconnected, take child's pose. Take a nice deep breath here. Slowly exhale the breath. On your next inhale, bend your knees, glance forward. Exhale, travel to the front of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift, hands to your shins. Exhale, forward fold. Let's bring the big toes together, slight sliver in the heels. Drop your hips down, preparing for Surya Namaskar B. We start with chair pose. Inhale, Utkatasana. Bring your arms up, right in line with your ears. Okay, if your shoulders are real tight, you always have the option to bring your hands to your heart. Just take a moment here to sit your hips back so that you're sitting into the heels. Your knees are straight, your knees are right over those ankles. All right, I'm gonna adjust my monitor here so you can see.
Good. Building up the heat here. Make sure that lower back is not arched. You're snapping that belly tight in towards your spine. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, fly the arms back. Palms facing the ground. Drive your fingertips to the back wall. Take a moment here. Notice where your weight has gone, keeping your weight into those heels. Keep your belly engaged. Listen close on your next inhale. We rise single leg. Tadasana. So your left leg lifts, you're standing on your right leg, and your arms are up overhead. Snap that belly tight, take a deep breath in. On your exhale, airplane pose. Let's send the left leg straight to the back wall, slight bends in the right knee. Square your left hip to the ground. If this is too challenging, simply drop that left foot to the ground. Really push through that left heel, infinite energy through that left hip. Push back. Reach those fingertips back, take a deep breath in. And slowly exhale, left foot down. Stay in airplane with the arms, eyes on the ground. Now we're gonna make a big transition here. On your next inhale, warrior two. So we're gonna windmill the arms around and we're gonna open up that right hip. Your chest is facing forward. Your arms are locked out. Notice if that right knee is directly over that right ankle. Notice if that left leg is straight and strong. When you look at your mat, you want your right heel to be in alignment with the arch of the left foot. All right, and then push the feet energetically together. You should feel a nice level of engagement in your hips and your belly as you do that. Take a moment here. Let's take our gaze in between our right fingertips. Drop your shoulders away from the ears and then squeeze your biceps and triceps to your arms, your humerus bone. Really push it in, firm them. So if someone came up to you, they cannot push your arms down. They're too strong. You guys are warriors. On your next inhale, reverse warrior, reach back. Let's allow that left arm to relax on that left leg. Reach through that right arm. So rather than collapsing through the back, we're reaching up and then over. Let's keep depth in that right knee. You have the option to look up at your right fingertips or down, whatever feels good in your neck. Good, deep breath in, keep depth in that right knee. On your exhale, windmill the hands around, pivot that back foot and hold low lunge. Let's plant that left hand down to the ground. Right knee is facing forward. On your next inhale, twisting low lunge. Let's take our gaze over our right shoulder. If this hurts your neck, you can always look down, but just notice where your left shoulder is. It's right over that left wrist. That left leg is locked out. So squeeze the left quadricep and then push that right knee in through the center of your body. Nice and slow, take a deep breath in. Exhale through your vinyasa, we take that right foot back and we flow. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. On our next inhale, bend your knees, glance forward. Exhale, travel to the front of your mat. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, forward fold. Bring the big toes together, slight sliver in the heels. On your inhale, Utkatasana, chair pose. So we come back to chair again. Snap that belly tight. Relax your shoulders. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, fly the arms back. Palms facing the ground. Reach through the fingertips. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Let's keep depth in those legs. Good. Inhale, sweep the arms up. This time you're balancing on your left leg. Your right leg is lifted. Single leg Tadasana. Snap that belly tight. Squeeze your left glute. Find your stability in that left foot. Take a deep breath in. On your exhale, airplane pose. Let's bring that right leg straight back. Reach through the fingertips. Stabilize through that left foot. And then really reach. The more you engage your muscles, the more balance you'll feel in your body. So if that right leg is just hanging out in the air, it's gonna be real tough on your back. But if you push through that right heel and you push that, the
glute tight and you push your belly tight without holding your breath, you're gonna feel so balanced. Stabilize through all three anchors of that left foot, your big toe, your small toe, and your heel. Good, deep breath in. Bend that left knee, exhale, step it back. Good, big transition of warrior two. Inhale, let's drop that right heel down, windmill those hands around. Chest is gonna face the back wall this time. Your arms are straight and strong here. So I'm gonna flip around here so you can see me. Just notice what's going on with the mat. Left heel is in alignment with the arch of the back foot. That right leg is locked out. Left knee is at a 90 degree angle. Arms are locked out, lock them out. Just visualize Jay-Z coming up to you. She can't push you down, you're so strong. Take your gaze in between your left fingertips and then notice if that left knee is facing forward. You're gonna feel an openness in that left hip. Good, inhale deeply. Stay for the exhale. On your next inhale, reverse your warrior. Allow that right arm to relax on that right thigh. If you want, you can even hook the right arm behind you to avoid any unnecessary pushing in that right leg. And then reach up all the way up to the sky before we get that lateral flexion toward the back wall. Good, find that depth in the left knee. Take a deep breath in. On your exhale, windmill the hands around. Pivot that right foot right away. Low lunge. Place the right hand to the earth and then notice what's going on with the left knee. Keep it straight, lock that right thigh out. Inhale, twisting low lunge. Reach your left hand to the wall, or the ceiling rather. Lift all the way up. We don't want to collapse down into that right shoulder. Good, take a deep breath in. On your exhale, let's go through our flow, vinyasa, high to low plank. Lower halfway down, elbows in, inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Good, let's breathe in here. I'm gonna turn myself around. Take two deep breaths. Relax your arms, or rather your head and neck. Notice where your weight goes. As we get tired, our body starts to compensate. So before it goes into those compensatory patterns, we have to check in and just put ourselves in the right position. And that's why child pose is always an option if you need to relax with just a breath. We're gonna flow three times through Surya Namaskar B, breath to movement. Allow your breath to guide your flow. On your next inhale, bend your knees, glance forward. Exhale, travel to the front of your mat. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, forward fold. Utkatasana, chair pose. Nice and slow, inhale those arms up. Exhale, fly the arms back, palms facing the earth. Inhale, left leg lifts, single legged Tadasana. Exhale, airplane. Nice and slow. Deep breath in. Exhale, step that left foot back. Inhale, warrior two. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, low lunge. Pivot that left foot right away. Inhale, twisting low lunge. Exhale, chaturanga dandasana, high to low plank. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, bend your knees, glance forward. Exhale, travel to the front of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, airplane those arms. Inhale, right leg lifts, single legged Tadasana. Exhale, airplane pose, nice and slow. Push through that right heel. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, step that right foot back. Inhale, warrior two, pivot that right heel down, left knee is facing forward. Stay for the exhale. 90 degrees in that left knee, inhale, reverse. Exhale, windmill the hands around, pivot that right foot, low lunge. Inhale, twisting low lunge. Exhale, vinyasa, high to low plank. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog.
Breathe in, bend your knees.
Exhale, travel to the front of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, airplane arms. Inhale, left leg lifts. Exhale, full expression, airplane. Deep breath in. Exhale, step it back. Inhale, warrior two. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, reach back. Exhale, windmill those hands around. Pivot that left foot. Let's take your left hand to the ground. Inhale, twisting low lunge. Exhale, vinyasa, high to low plank. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, bend your knees, glance forward. Travel to the front of your mat on your exhale. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, fly. Inhale, right leg lifts. Exhale, airplane pose. Plenty of time for breathing here. Deep inhale through your nose. Exhale, step it back. Inhale, warrior two. We stay for the exhale. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, windmill the hands around. Pivot the right foot right away. Right hand stays down. Inhale, twisting low lunge. Exhale, vinyasa, high to low plank. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a deep breath here, everybody. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. We flow one more time. Breath in, bend your knees, glance forward. Exhale, travel to the front of your mat. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, Utkatasana, chair pose. Exhale, fly. Inhale, left leg lifts. Exhale, airplane. Take a deep breath in, find length. Exhale, step it back slow. Right knee over that right ankle. Inhale, warrior two. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, pivot that foot around. Stay here, left hand plants down. Inhale, twisting low lunge and pause for a moment. Let's add a little challenge here. Let's stack the right foot on top of the left. Take a side plank. Lift your hips up. If you want to abduct that right leg, you can. If you want to take tree, you can. Play around with this posture a little bit. Take a deep breath in. On your exhale, vinyasa, high to low plank. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. One more side, then we recover. Take a deep breath, look forward, bend your knees. Exhale, travel to the front of your mat. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, Utkatasana, chair pose. Exhale, fly. Inhale, right leg lifts. Exhale, airplane. Reach through the crown of your head, reach through the fingertips, push through that right heel, take a deep breath in. Exhale, step it back. Inhale, warrior two. We stay for the exhale. Inhale, reverse, reach up. Exhale, windmill those hands around. Pause for a moment. Whatever you did on the other side, let's do it again. Just play around, let the kid come out for a moment. We all got it in us. Take a deep breath in. On your exhale, we flow high to low plank. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. All right. Take a moment here. If you want to drop to your knees, you can. That feels yummy. All right, everybody. We are going to do some core. All right. You got 4 minutes of core just to break things up, get that belly nice and engaged. So let's bring yourself to your back. We're going to start with a basic crunch. So once you're down here, hands are behind the neck. Elbows out to the side, nice and slow. We're going to pump it up. Here we go. In 3, 2, 1, just pump and pulse. Allow your head to relax into your hands, eyes on the ceiling. As you come up, you exhale. Exhale, inhale on the way down. You notice if you're pulling your neck at all, allow your neck to relax. Let your head fall into your hands. We got 20 seconds. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, three, two, and one. Place your hands on the side. Bring your legs up to the sky. Find a spot on your ceiling. You're gonna bring your toes right to that spot. Let's not swing the legs at all. Come straight up and down. Work in those lower abdomen. Push up. Push up, nice and controlled. Use your arms as anchors. Eyes on the ceiling. Straight up, straight up. Your goal is to push to that point on your ceiling, straight at that point. So precise movements, people. 20 seconds. Last five. Good, bring your feet down, feet hip distance. Chest up, shoulders off the ground. You're gonna tap your heels, opposite heel. Push and push, working those obliques, side to side. If you need to support your neck, simply just have your hands underneath your neck. Keep it strong here, we got 20 seconds. Last 10. Three, two, and one. Bring yourself down, feet on the ground, or you could start at the top of the exercise. We're gonna do leg lowering here. Flex the toes, nice and slow, come down, real slow. The lower you go, the more challenging in the core. So if you're arching your lower back, don't go as low. So you're coming down slow, you're coming up slow. Zero momentum. Hands are on the floor, not under your back. Keep that belly super tight, everybody. Last 20. Keep it strong. We got 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Feet on the ground. Imagine a rope. I want you to climb that rope. Go up. Reach. 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 30 seconds. Then you're done with core. Take it to the finish line here. Keep your hips on the ground. Reach. Reach. Climb high. Shoulders off the ground. Almost there. 15. All right, we got 3, 2, and 1. Let's stretch our arms overhead, all the way overhead. Let our legs fall all the way down. Close your eyes for a moment. That we breathe deeply at all times. Let's bring our hands to our side body. Let's bring our feet directly under our knees. We're going to slide our tailbone forward and then slowly come up into bridge pose. Keeping your eyes on the ceiling or your eyes remaining closed. This is a great oppositional stretch, a lot of spinal flexion. And with this, you're opening up the spine in extension while we stretch out our core. Want a little bit more, you can go underneath your back and then walk yourself side to side and allow your scapula to act as two pillows directly underneath your heart. And then clasp your hands underneath your glutes and then push your knuckles towards your heels and feel that length through your neck and your shoulders. Beautiful. Take a deep breath in. Slowly release your hips to the ground, one vertebra at a time. We hug our knees into our chest, rock your hips side to side. Good. So to come out of our supine position into our down dog, I always like to flow. So I'm going to demonstrate. You just want to rotate your head to face the camera. You're going to take your hands underneath your hamstrings. Rock and roll the length of your spine three times. And on the third rock, you cross your legs at the top, you plant your hands on the ground, you bring your legs back, and you go through your flow. And then you make your way into down dog. Try it out. You could always just go back to down dog. There's absolutely no judgments in yoga. Yoga is a time to play and let go, but number one responsibility is obviously our health and our safety. So if you don't feel safe doing that, then listen to your body. Good. We're going to do a little bit of balancing here, just a little bit. So on your next inhale, let's send the right leg straight to the back wall. Find length through that right hip. And then on your exhale, step it through low lunge. Good. Inhale right up to crescent lunge. Reach your arms to the sky. And then notice what's going on with your belly. If you're tilting your hips forward, let's untilt the hips, lift up out of your lower back. You could straighten your leg if you have it in your practice. Some of you might feel better if you bend that back knee, almost like a lunge. Keep that belly engaged the whole time. Take a deep breath in. Stay for the exhale. Good. On your next inhale, we're going to come into airplane pose again. We've been here. You're going to push that left heel to the back wall. Snap that belly tight. Reach through your fingertips. Just really find your stability here. Good. Take a deep breath in. Stay for the exhale. Good. On your inhale, rise to single leg Tadasana. Left leg lifts a little bit here. And on your exhale, we're going to place the left foot on the right thigh, preparing for tree pose. So you could actually use the guidance of your left hand to bring it into the inner thigh. You want to avoid putting that foot on your knee. So I'm going to face the camera for a moment. You could either go to your calf, or you can go right into that little pocket, okay? And there's a synergy here. The way to create balance in the body is you wanna consider that left foot pushing into that right thigh, and then you wanna think of lifting that right thigh up. Find something in your room that's not moving. It's called your drishti, your point of focus. Without that point of focus, it seems like the world is moving around you, which could impact your balance. So just take a moment to calm the minds down so you can create stability in the body. If you want to grow your branches, you could extend your arms out or up above your head like a tree, or you could keep your hands at your heart center. Visualize energy going through the crown of your head as you lift up through the crown of your head, rising up toward the sun. We're going to do a little bit more proprioception here. You're going to extend that left arm out. Keep your right arm, or hands rather, in the middle of your chest. And you can, if you have in your practice, to rotate your head to face the left fingertips while keeping your hips facing forward. It's going to feel much more challenging. So if you want to back out of it, simply rotate the head back to center. If you want to grow that right arm overhead, you have the option to do so. It's almost like an L. Good. Take a deep breath in. And then nice and slow, let's come out of it. We're facing the front of our mat. Let's drop our left foot down. Inhale, reach your arms overhead. Exhale, forward fold, slight bends in your knees. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale through your vinyasa, high to low plank. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. On your next inhale, send the left leg straight to the back wall. Exhale, slowly stepping through, low lunge. Good. Inhale, rise, low lunge here. So crescent lunge rather, your arms come overhead. If you did so on the other side, let's really bring that hip forward, keeping your hips neutral. Back knee is bent slightly, or at a 90 degree angle. Feel real strong in your feet. You want to feel grounded as if you're doing a warrior. Keep your belly engaged, take a deep breath in. On your exhale, we go into airplane pose. Launch onto that left foot, push that right heel to the back wall. Reach through the fingertips and then reach through the crown of your head. So really bring your chest almost upward without arching your lower back. And then tuck your chin slightly. Just feel as if your back is in one plane. And then keep pushing through that right heel, firm through that right thigh. Take a deep breath in. We stay for the exhale. On your next inhale, swoop that right leg up, single leg Tadasana. And on your exhale, we guide that right foot to our inner left thigh into tree pose. I'm gonna rotate myself to face the camera here. So whatever you did on the first side, if you were on your calf, you could do that for this side. But just make sure everything feels completely in balance. You know, once you're just balancing on one leg, it's very easy to feel off kilter. The trick is to really push that right foot into the left thigh. Rotate that right knee to the back wall. Keep that belly snapped in tight. If you grew your branches on the other side, perhaps you grow them on this side. Liberated in your body and your mind. This is where personal growth happens, is that visualization of us growing higher than where we're at today. Good, nice and slow, bring that left hand to the center of your heart and extend that right arm out to the side. Take your mudra fingers, your middle finger to your thumb. And then you're gonna slowly rotate your gaze to your right hand. All right, it's gonna feel real challenging with your balance, but just believe in yourself here. All right, if you fall out of the pose, it's okay, just get right back in. If you wanna extend that left arm overhead, you can. If you wanna take your gaze forward, that's okay. Nice and slow, bring your hands to your heart center. We drop the right foot down. Inhale, reach your arms overhead. Let's take one more back bend. Exhale, open up the chest. Inhale, rise. Exhale, forward fold, straight back. Bend your knees. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale for your final vinyasa for the day. Maybe throw in a second push-up here. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a deep breath in. Open mouth, exhale. Inhale, bend your knees, glance forward. Exhale, travel to a seat. Very nice, everybody. We're gonna slowly lower down to our mat, one vertebra at a time. So send your hips forward. And then just come down real slow. I'm just gonna face the camera on my mat. Nice and slow, lower down. And hug your knees into your chest, rock your hips side to side. And slowly bring your feet over your knees. Happy baby. Nice and slow, just play around here. Allow your hips to open up. If you wanna extend your legs out to the side, you can. If this is too aggressive, stay in happy baby. Close your eyes and just enjoy the magic of this hip opener. All right, nice and slowly drop your legs on the ground. Real slow, take your left leg over your right thigh. Figure four. You're gonna thread through the needle, reach under to your right hamstring, and then just opening up that hip. Breathe in deeply, or you can even soften your breath. The goal in here is to wind down our practice. Just allowing ourselves to fill the space with just a sense of pure calmness. Time was of no essence and there's nowhere to be, but right here in this space of calmness, your mind and your body would find pure unity. Just take a deep breath in. Pure breath out. You slowly switch sides. Let's drop the left foot down. Take the right foot over the left thigh. Flex the right toes, protecting that right knee. Slowly bring your left leg into your chest, reach through. Figure four. With every breath, find that right knee rotating away from your body. Feeling that stretch in your right glute. Beautiful. Let's slowly undo our legs. Let's bring your arms like a big T, knees to your chest, and then slowly drop your knees to the right. Take your gaze over your left shoulder. Right hand could guide your legs downward. Close your eyes. Just allow the breath to relax. On your next inhale, slowly bring your knees to the other side. Drop your knees to the left. Take your gaze over your right shoulder. Beautiful. Slowly bring your knees back to center. And then let's bring your knees into your chin and your chin all the way to your knees. Hug yourself to the tightest little ball ever. Take a deep breath in. Let's breathe in a little bit more right here. And then exhale, final resting Shavasana. Let it go. Vasana's corpse pose, it represents an opportunity to where there's absolutely no purpose at all, but complete relaxation. Just relax the muscles in your legs. Allow yourself to sink deeper into the earth. Dissolve your shoulder blades into the ground. And feel the weight of your head into the earth as you allow your face muscles to completely relax. Soften the breath. Shavasana represents corpse pose. Realizing that once we're in corpse pose, we can't bring anything that doesn't serve us into our lives, because we can't do anything but just be. So as we re-enter our day, we have that conscious decision as to what we will and will not pick up once we leave our yoga mat. So decide in this space that you will completely surrender to all the things that do not serve you. Just visualize those things just gone out of your mind and out of your physical body. Feel the sense of calmness. The more calm we remain, the more opportunity we can gain those things that do belong in our minds and our lives. So as we re-enter our night, we wiggle our fingers and our toes, creating life and movement. On your next inhale, reach your arms over your head. And then slowly bring your right foot to the ground. And then bring your left foot to the ground. And using your left arm as a pillow, you're going to rock your way to your left side, keeping your eyes closed. Just stay here for a moment, feel position. Once you feel ready, with your eyes remaining closed, come to the front of your mat with your legs crossed, and you're going to sit up real tall in your body. To create mudra, fingers in the hands, your palms are facing the sky. Sit up tall in your spine and just visualize this pure sense of happiness and love and fulfillment that you get to take with you as we exit this practice. The most beautiful sense of fulfillment that you can offer your mind and your body, that freedom to choose what you invite back into your life. Let's bring our hands to our heart and feel your heartbeat right within you. Let's bring our thumbs to our third eye center, your seat of intuition. Allowing all of your thoughts be filled with love. And as we seal our practice, we acknowledge and respect each other. The vibrations we shared in this hour is so far appreciated by myself. I thank you so much for joining me this evening. We bow forward to seal our practice. And in honor of one another, we say, Namaste. Beautiful job, everybody. Beautiful job.